last weekend, I actually did a talk on Maths and the Simpsons here in Melbourne, and I'm going to split this up into three different videos. So today you get the first one, nice and short. We'll be familiar, some of you will be familiar with this first clip, but I think I've got a few twists and turns to add to all this, which will entertain most of you. All right, here we go.
Hey, there's something you don't see in a toilet every day. Anybody lose their glasses? Last chance. Woohoo! The sum of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining side.
That's a right triangle, you idiot!
This is great. Anyway, so what does he say? What does he say? Well, that. And some of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining side. Which sounds very similar to this guy, right? Pythagoras, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Well, it sounds very similar. So what, if he actually meant to say this, what were his mistakes? Well, the guy in the background already pointed out one of them. It's not an isosceles triangle, it's a right triangle. Okay, what else? There's other things in there that don't work.
Any two sides?
Any two sides, yeah, that's fine. So any two sides, it's got to be those two here in Pythagoras. And then there's one more, which is of course...
Oh yeah, the sum of the square roots.
The sum of the square roots, yeah. So sum of the square roots doesn't work. Any two sides doesn't work. So that's wrong. But I got it's got me thinking. I mean, Homer knows what an isosceles triangle is. This is ridiculous. So maybe he actually did not have Pythagoras in mind. Maybe he learned it somewhere else. And there's actually another Simpsons episode that gives you a bit of a hint where he may have learned it.
Ooh, there's new marshmallows in the Belfast Charms.
No, that's Bart cereal. It's the only way I can get him to take his vitamins. Eat up!
The sum of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining side.
That's not right.
Yes, it is. They're my lines as a scarecrow in The Wizard of Oz.
The scarecrow in The Wizard of Oz. Actually, if you go to the movie and you find... The scarecrow.
Sum of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle is equal to the square root of the remaining side.
Oh, joy! Rapture! I've got a brain!
So he says this after he's got the brain, right? Well...
It's like he got a bad deal.
He got a bad deal. But maybe not. Maybe he's right, you know? Just because this sounds similar to Pythagoras doesn't mean that it has to be. You know, it might still be correct, right? So let's have a really, really close look. Maybe it is correct, right? So here's an isosceles triangle. So what makes a triangle isosceles? We've got two sides that have equal lengths, okay? Or two angles here, let's say. All right, now what does he say? He says, if I do the square root of this and add to it the square root of that, you get the square root of this. But he also says you can do this with any two sides, so I should also be able to kind of start square root of this plus square root of that is square root of that. So let's also write down that one here. Now have a look at this one here. It's okay, but I mean, you've got two times as square root of a on two sides of the equation. So what can we do? We can just cancel it out. Yeah? So we cancel it out. Goes, and then what's left over is square root of b is equal to zero, which means that b is equal to zero. No.
So
you get a line, right? I mean, maybe you consider this as an isosceles triangle, but usually not, right? So, I mean, there's definitely something that's not quite right. But let's just forget about this any two sides business, okay? Maybe just this was meant, right? So square root of a plus square root of a is equal to square root of b. Maybe he meant that one, right? Well, let's just have a look. So what we do is we pull those two things together. So it's 2 times square root of a. What do we do now? Pretty obvious. We square to get rid of the square roots. So we get this one here. And now we'll have a really, really close look at it. And actually we can do this in pictures here. So what this says is we've got like a, and we've got a, and b is 4 times as long as a. And it's pretty obvious you can't make any triangle out of anything like this, right? So just forget about it. It's a big, nah, it's not gonna work, right? So it's pretty wrong. But it can get even wronger. So let's just have a look at like any triangle whatsoever and have a look where you can actually get a square root of a plus square root of b is equal to square root of c. So again, to get rid of the square roots, we just square the whole thing, right? So square here. So now what do we get here? We get the first times guy squared plus two times this times that plus, okay? So what's this one squared?
A.
A. And then we get plus.
Two square root of a square root of b.
Yep, that's right. And then the last one is?
B.
B, okay. And then on this side?
C.
C. Okay, cool. Now just rearrange this a little bit and you get a plus b plus
what's
something. C, right? So basically what this says is that C is a little bit longer than A and B put together. Right? So there's A, there's B, and C is a little bit longer. And again, it's pretty obvious. You can't make any triangles out of this. Right? So it's pretty wrong. Also, I mean, this is isosceles triangles in the plane. What happens if you actually kind of look at triangles maybe on a sphere or on a weird surface or anything like this? Can you actually get the Scarecrow's theorem or Homer's theorem to work anywhere? Well, in the plane, what really kills this one here is the fact that in any triangle, A and B always add up to something that's bigger than C. And basically, the Scarecrow theorem contradicts that, right? So what we're really aiming for is a world in which this guy here is not satisfied. It's called a triangle inequality, okay? And it actually turns out that it's very hard to find anything reasonable where this doesn't hold. So for example, if you look at triangles on a sphere, they all satisfy this. So even on a sphere, the Scarecrow's theorem doesn't work, or Homer's theorem doesn't work. But you know, there's lots of mathematicians out there who know about lots and lots of really, really strange worlds. So maybe one of you has an idea for a strange world where we can actually make this work, maybe just in one instance. Okay. Right. Now I actually also started digging to see whether I can actually find Pythagoras. Now Pythagoras actually does pop up in The Simpsons. I know of two instances. And actually one of your missions is going to be to figure out where exactly in those clips Pythagoras pops up. Maybe some of you actually know of other instances of Pythagoras or Scarecrow or Homer's theorem in The Simpsons that I'd really like to know about it. Even other movies. Other episodes, other TV episodes. I'd be really interested in finding out. And for the Simpsons lovers among you, as I said before, you know, pinpoint all the episodes where these things are from. Okay, let's have a look at the first clip and see whether you can see Pythagoras somewhere in there.
I want a colossal donut, just like the one on the sign.
Donuts!
That's false advertising!
Sorry, sir. No refunds.
I paid for a colossal donut. And I'm gonna get a colossal donut.
That's a tough one. We may have to do this one frame by frame. But we also get a big hint in the credit. Okay, the second one should be pretty obvious. Anyway, so that's it for today.
battery low. My name is Dr. Glenn Pierce, and by now, you may have realized that all of this has happened exactly the way it was supposed to. You see, everyone who comes to the Institute does so because they feel that they are no longer in control of something important to them. But, more often than not, the problem is not that the problems we face can't be solved. The problem is that we become so afraid of failure that we refuse to see our problems from a new perspective. And so, we do the same things again and again and again. And therein, of course, we find exactly the failure we were looking for. Be a struggle, and you will always have problems. But today, you have the chance to see things differently. Even though it meant facing obstacles that seemed impossible at first, you thought outside the box, and you overcame them. Because you saw things from every angle, you understood them for what they really were. Because you kept moving forward, no matter how far off the path you were told you were headed, or how unexpected it became, you found your way. Back in the real world. And some part of you will say that none of this was real. So how could it have really meant anything? But just like the power of perspective itself, it will have been as real as you believed it to be. All you've got to do is wait.